All right. So I don't know. I guess it's Christmas time, and I'm feeling oddly simpatico, sentimental towards my parents-in-laws from Utah. No, not Utah. From England. I haven't talked to them, and I hope they're doing well health-wise. With the diabetes and so I don't know. I'll try the SMS or something out. I'm not doing well with my data plans, but good holidays to you. I hope. That's tough. When you're getting older, this is just it. I'll go and help you. I'm thinking of that also as an idea. I can go and help you in your aged years. That's an idea. But right now, I was also thinking about a genealogy center. They have them in France. They have, how should I say it? It's just like a shop. It's just like a storefront shop. People walk into, and there is a genealogy person, and talking to you about it. And I guess you give them information, and it. So instead of having it just at special locations, it might be an idea as a, what do we call those things? A multi-market chain. No, they call them trans hopping around the world, like McDonald's. One of those, a chain, of genealogy shops. So that would be interesting, because people like it, and that's just the way it goes. And it's something smart to do for everything, for everyone, so you don't get strange. And so anyway, I'm also here talking about odd ideas for Christmas, because maybe you don't want to go Christmas shopping. And I'm like, oh my gosh, my little brother, big brother, he is big brother, but he's little brother. He went to Mexico in his youth, when he was, I don't know, maybe 20 years old or so. And he helped out at an orphanage there. So there's a picture here of him dishing out food at an orphanage in Mexico with the little children. And it's quite sweet. It's quite sweet. I believe he was there for 2 3 months even. It could have been a long time, but he was there a while, and learning Spanish, and then yet also helping the little orphans. So there they are, and I imagine he's giving them some food on the plate also, not just eating it himself, but so good for him. But that was a gift, that was a gift given from my father and my mother to him, and so he was allowed that. So that's an odd idea, I know it, but if you just want to give a monetary gift, it's kind of a gift challenge, isn't it, for the young? Well, send you off to an orphanage, and then pay for your trip. So there you go. There's an idea, different. It's a different one to open at Christmas, that's for sure. And then the kid will say, no, I don't want to go. I just want to be, whatever. I don't want to go. And I'll be like, well, yeah, what do you do then when they say they don't want to go? What do you do then? It's like, well, that becomes a problem, doesn't it? It does become a problem. Because there is something learned at this stage, at this state, going and doing such a compassionate service. There is something learned at that state. And when the child says no, he doesn't want to, or she says she doesn't want to, I can understand not sending a female, perhaps, in that environment, but maybe, it's odd. It would be an odd thing to turn down. That's all. So yeah, I don't know. I don't know. There's a lot of that going on. Anyway, what was that? Gosh, think of all of the elders this time of the year and give them extra, what do you call it? I don't know. I guess they, an extra think about at least, because they do fall apart. They do fall apart also, as much as we fall apart in our depressions of Christmas. And I think a lot of the Christmas depression is attributed to sugars because of the rise and fall of all of the sugar eats. Yeah, a lot of sugary gifts don't help. Anyway, that was it. Yeah, so a genealogy center is an idea for a chain across America. Yeah, little genealogy centers. So there.